Hello friends, welcome to JSONmania Vlogs. Today I will be addressing an issue that most of the working people face, that is how to withdraw our PF amount online. Now you will be thinking that what is so difficult in withdrawing our PF amount online? It is our money. Yes, it is our money, but it may be much difficult to have it in our account online. I am telling you this because recently I was struggling with the same issue. Most of the HR people are also unaware about the online procedure to withdraw it. After speaking to various HR professionals and watching various YouTube videos that are very complex in nature to understand, I hereby would like to present to you the online procedure of PF withdrawal without getting taxed. Please watch the video till the end, and if you like the video, please don't forget to like, comment, share and subscribe to my channel. Also, please press the bell icon. Without further ado, I'll take you to the online PF claim procedure. This is the EPFO portal. We have to log in. First of all, you have to register yourself on the EPFO portal. To register, you have to fill the details, that is your name, UAN and the phone number on which you wish to get the OTP. UAN means Unified Account Number. You can find your Unified Account Number in your salary slips. Once you register, or if you have already registered like me, then log in to the UAN portal. Just enter the UAN number, password and the CAPTCHA, then press on sign in. So now we are logged into the UAN portal. It is asking for e-nomination facilities available with a e-sign. Please file your nomination immediately if not filed just yet. It is optional, you can file it now or later. Now this is the UAN portal, the member profile. Here Aadhaar card, PAN card should be verified. If your Aadhaar card and PAN card are not verified, not an issue, not to worry. You can simply visit a mobile store and ask them to update your Aadhaar and PAN for KYC. Nowadays they do it by biometric. They do biometric and eye scanning for KYC updation. Then after the KYC updation, your Aadhaar and PAN on the UAN portal will be showing as verified. Like this is now verified. Okay. Now to withdraw the PF, you have to go to the online services. Claim form 3119 10C and 10D. The first option, you have to click on that. There it is, the online claim form. The member details. Please check your employer, your name, date of birth, father's name and mobile number that you have already registered on which you wish to get the OTP in future. They should be correct and accurate. Your Aadhaar number, last four digit, PAN number and bank account number. Now you have to verify your bank account number, that is the last four digit you have to verify. Click on verify. IFSC code, everything, please check that. Agree to the terms. Now service details, come to service details. Here it will be mentioned DOJ EPF, that is date of joining PF and date of joining pension, and this is the date of leaving PF and date of leaving exit, date of exit PF and date of exit pension and reason of leaving. These two, date of joining PF and PF, pension, the employer would update it as soon as you join the organization. And once you exit from the organization, then after the full and final, the employer has to update these three details as well. That is the date of exit EPF, date of exit EPS and the reason of leaving. Without updating these three details, you can't claim for your PF and pension amount, because without updating these three details, if you proceed for the online claim, it will show as online claim in advance. That is, if you are applying for advance money, that is advance PF, that is if you have any emergency like your marriage, for marriage or house reconstruction like that, you can apply for advance PF also. So now we will proceed to online claim. I want to apply for only PF withdrawal, that is form number 19. Only pension withdrawal, that is form number 10C. PF advance form number 31, that we have. This PF advance form we don't have to fill right now. Okay, if you are taking your PF amount in advance, then you have to fill this form. Okay, if date of exit PF, date of exit EPS and reason of leaving are there, then you can't fill this advance form. You have to fill these two forms. A PF amount has two components, that is the PF and our pension amount. So don't forget to withdraw the pension amount as well. For that you have to fill the form number 10C. Okay, so you have to fill two forms. And one more thing I would like to share with you friends, that you have to fill form number 15G if applicable. When it is applicable, I'll tell you. If your tenure of employment is less than 5 years, or if your PF amount that you are expecting is more than 50,000, then you are liable for tax. So in order to get rid of that tax, you have to fill the form number 15G. Okay, now earlier we used to fill the form number 15G manually, and then we have to visit the PF office to submit it. Now the PF organization has done it, made it simpler for us. That is how in this only PF withdrawal form number 19, if we click on this, it will also give us an option for form number 15G, to attach a form number 15G, attach a file where we can attach our form number 15G. Okay, the link to the form number 15G I will put it in the description box. You can check and download it from there. And once you download it, just take a print, fill the form and get it scanned and convert it into a PDF form, into a PDF format, which will be less than 1 MB. It should be one and less than 1 MB. Otherwise it won't be able to, you won't be able to attach the same form number 15G. So you have to convert it into a PDF format, which will be less than 1 MB. Then you have to fill rest of the form number 19, then submit. Then you have to fill form number 10C, then submit and wait for the amount. It will be credited to your account, bank account that you have mentioned, within 7 to 10 days. Okay, normally it takes 4 to 5 days only. Okay, maximum it can take 10 to 15 days. Nowadays it is very fast. So within 7 days you will have your PF amount as well as your pension amount without getting taxed. So please don't forget to fill the form number 15G as well. I'll show you right now. If I click on form PF withdrawal form number 19, date of leaving is less than 2 months. That is, my date of exit was 30th October. So today is only 21st December. So I'm short of 9 days. To after 9 days, I can withdraw my PF and pension amount as well, because then it will be more than 2 months. So after 2 months, after 60 days only, you can withdraw your PF amount and pension amount. And please don't forget to fill the form number 15G if applicable. Hope this video helped you. If this video was helpful, please don't forget to like, share, subscribe, comment, and please press the bell icon. And please have a look at the description, because I'll be leaving some important links, that is the form number 15G link, the EPFO portal link, the UAN portal link. So I'll be sharing it in the description box. Please go through it. And that's all for today. Please stay tuned to JSOmania Vlogs. Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year in advance. Thank you. Bye bye.